Scientists dedicate their lives researching and making profound discoveries. The ultimate goal for a scientist should be to do something good for humanity. Sometimes, however, truly horrible experiments are conducted. My name is Gimmons, and today we'll cover some of the worst human experiments in history. A short disclaimer, I picked some of the most controversial human experiments of the past century for this video. This video is not going to be lighthearted, it's rather upsetting, and there are many crude experiments, so please be aware. Operation Midnight Climax. The first set of experiments was conducted in the US. In the 1950s, the CIA secretly sponsored a set of experiments which are now known as Operation Midnight Climax. The goal of these experiments was to find out whether we can control the minds of unknown victims. Yeah, that sounds straight out of a bad sci-fi movie. So, how can we test that, you might ask? Well, a couple of CIA agents bought an apartment in San Francisco and turned it into a brothel. And in one room they incorporated a mirror. This was a one-way mirror, and on the other side was an extra room. The agents used this room to spy on the unknown victims. The agents then hired sex workers to drug the customers without their consent. Then they tried to control their minds by making them revealing random secrets. The experiments went on and on, but then the agents went even a step further. They started drugging people at random places. And this was really crazy, as it didn't matter if you spent a day at a beach or you went to a concert, no one was safe. The experiments overall ran for 10 years and provided the government with extensive knowledge on topics such as mind-altering drugs and surveillance technology. Fortunately, the experiment was finally shut down in 1965. And to top it off, one of the agents who was involved in the study later admitted to his boss to taking drugs himself and saying that this experiment was, quote, fun, fun, fun. The facial expression experiments. No one died during the facial expression experiments, but the nature of this study is still just so disturbing. In 1924, at the University of Minnesota, psychologist Carney Landis began an experiment to study common facial expressions. Specifically, he wanted to find out whether everyone's expressions of emotions such as happiness, disgust, or shock looks the same. The question is, how did he try to provoke disgust or shock in people? Yeah, you know this is going to be bad. The scientists just started to recruit a bunch of people and drew some lines on the faces to see their emotions better. Then they underwent 17 stages of the experiment. First they did quite harmless things, such as listening to popular music or smelling ammonia. Then it became a bit weirder. Firecrackers were exploded underneath the subject's chair and they had to share their most embarrassing secrets. The scientists then showed them, let's say, adult pictures and they had to touch frogs while receiving electric shocks. Well, and that wasn't enough though. In the final stage, the scientists told the participants to behead a rat. As you can imagine, by this stage of the experiments, the participants were so overwhelmed they couldn't really process what was happening. And overall, a third did what the scientists told them to do. But the ones who refused to behead a rat were also not spared, as the scientist went on to behead it. He photographed all of their reactions and collected them together. Then he went to an auditorium of psychology students and they had to assess, just based on the pictures without knowing the context, how the participants felt. So, what was the outcome of this horrific experiment? Based on facial expressions alone, the students couldn't really assess how the participants felt. That's it. As you can imagine, many participants later reported to feel traumatized by the experiment. The monkey drug trials. This itself is not a human experiment, but it's still important to talk about it. In 1969, a series of experiments was conducted at the University of Michigan. The goal was to find out whether monkeys can get hooked on drugs. Yeah. At the start of the experiment, monkeys were housed in cubicles, barely bigger than themselves. At the center of one of the walls were two switches. The monkeys could press the switches. One injected a drug into a catheter which was implanted into the monkeys, and the other didn't release any drugs. The monkeys would initially press the switch out of curiosity and receive morphine, codeine, cocaine, amphetamines, and alcohol, among other drugs. When monkeys failed to initiate self-administration of a drug, the scientists started to drug them automatically just to see if they can get drug dependent. Yeah, and as it turns out, monkeys can get drug dependent. And it's really sad to read this study, the monkeys suffered a lot, they hallucinated, they vomited, they self-harmed, it was just horrible. And some monkeys even died during the experiments. As you can imagine, the study was and still is very controversial, as it just causes unnecessary suffering for animals. You can find the original study in the description, but be aware that it is really hard to read. Fortunately, such studies are not possible in today's society anymore. Japan's Unit 731. Okay, this set of human experiments is actually so horrible you cannot imagine it. Japan's Unit 731 was a notorious branch of Japanese army which conducted human experiments in the 1930s and 1940s. The goal was to test poisons, infectious diseases, and how much the human body can endure. For example, they infected the victims with the plague, anthrax, typhoid, or cholera. According to some sources, plague-ridden fleas were put into clay bombs which were then dropped onto civilians. And the soldiers also didn't stop there, they conducted vivisections. Vivisections are the practice of mutilating human body parts without anesthesia. And if you read about the reports, it's just unimaginable. The victims either directly passed away from the surgeries or were later executed. The experiments concluded with the end of the Second World War. Unfortunately, none of the scientists of Unit 731 was ever punished. You see, the US government helped to keep the experiments secret in exchange for information they gathered. It is estimated over 200,000 people died during these experiments. This is so horrible. The Monster Study. The Monster Study was one of the most controversial psychological human experiments of the past century. It was conducted by a speech pathologist called Wendell Johnson. Wendell Johnson was a stutterer when he was a child and he became obsessed with the causes of stuttering. So he sent a postgraduate student to an orphanage. Yeah, bad. To find out whether she can induce stuttering in orphans. Worse. As part of the study, the student experimented on 22 orphans and put them into two groups of stutterers and non-stutterers. The first group received positive speech therapy, meaning the fluency of the speech was praised. The second group, however, received negative speech therapy, meaning that they were constantly criticized for the speech. The children were interviewed every couple of weeks for the next months. And there were some devastating results. Children in the stutterer group who were originally extroverted and outgoing suddenly didn't talk much anymore. And they also became very anxious. One girl told that she doesn't talk to her best friend anymore because she's afraid that she will find out that she's a stutterer. The study finished after 6 months and Johnson concluded that kids who stuttered and were criticized for the speech were worse off than before. The postgraduate student later regretted her part in the study and she visited the orphanage a couple of times to praise all of their speech. It actually took a long while until the public really knew about these experiments. It was only in 2001 when a couple of articles were released. Survivors received some compensation for the traumas they had to endure during the study. Yeah, that was all horrible. The Tuskegee Syphilis Study. The Tuskegee Syphilis Study was carried out in 1932 by the Tuskegee Institute. The aim of the study was to find out how syphilis progresses. Syphilis is caused by a bacterium which is transmitted through sexual contact. Syphilis can have different outcomes and, if not treated, damages the brain, eyes, heart, and blood vessels. The study initially involved 600 African-American men, 399 with syphilis, 201 who did not have the disease. The men were not told what the scientists wanted to study, they just said that they had bad bloods. In exchange for the studies, the men received free medical examination and some free meals. The experiment was mainly to observe how syphilis progresses over time. And although the premise of this experiment is terrible, it even became worse. You see, at the start of this experiment, there was no cure for syphilis. But then penicillin became available. Penicillin and later other antibiotics are an effective way to cure syphilis. But instead of treating the men with antibiotics, the doctors actually told them not to seek any other medical advice and did not help them whatsoever. And the study continued for years and years. It was only 1972 when the press found out and they released an article about the Tuskegee syphilis study. The experiment was subsequently terminated and a lawsuit was filed resulting in an out-of-court settlement. Of the original 399 men, 28 died of syphilis and 100 died of related complications. Then a new law was passed and studies from now on had to have informed consent. Yeah, I mean, this is terrible, right? The Holocaust experiments. Being one of the most cruel regimes in history, the Third Reich was notorious for the installation of concentration camps. Unfortunately, some scientists used the supply of prisoners to conduct human experiments. One of the masterminds of these horrific human experiments was Joseph Mengele. Mengele was a famous doctor in the Third Reich and soon after arriving in Auschwitz he was nicknamed Todesengel, which is German for Angel of Death. He supervised the selection of incoming prisoners for either direct execution or for hard labor or his experiments. Mengele was especially interested in twins, and he just kept them separately from all the other prisoners. It must have been a bit weird in the beginning for the twins, since they didn't have to commit to any hard labor, but this wasn't out of kindness. Mengele thought the twins were the ideal test subjects for his perverse ideas of race theory. He often just suddenly came in and took one of the twins away and started his human experiments. He proceeded by infecting the hostage with various diseases, and he amputated limbs, and he also injected dyes into their eyes to see if their eye color changes. Another SS doctor called Sigmund Rascher was also keen to conduct human experimentation. In fact, he was one of the first to suggest high altitude experiments in concentration camps. Here, prisoners were put into pressure chambers, and the pressure was very quickly altered. These experiments were also often lethal, as you can imagine. Other prisoners in the concentration camps had to stay naked outside during cold nights and were then thrown into boiled water. And words cannot describe how sick these people actually were. You see, Rascher enjoyed his experiments. One of Rascher's superiors once suggested that if prisoners survived his experiments, they should be pardoned for life imprisonment. But Rascher refused and said that this is not necessary. I mean, how sick is even this dialogue? In an ironic twist of events, Rascher himself ended up in a concentration camp after it was found out that he committed various crimes. And with that, I don't mean his killing spree, but instead scientific fraud, fraud in general, and also killing his former lab member. After the Second World War, some responsible people went to trial and were executed, others went to prison. Some could flee from Germany, including Mengele, who died in Brazil in 1979. Yeah. He avoided trial throughout his whole life. His diaries were later found, and he largely showed no regrets for his actions. But I want to take a minute to talk to you about today's scientific rules and ethics, and how we can make sure that these experiments never happen again. Some of these experiments led to new international laws. And some new ethical codes have been formulated, such as the Nuremberg Code and later the Geneva Declaration and the Helsinki Declaration. And these state that no experiment should be conducted where people suffer lifelong injuries or any form of damage. And this is actually also what we saw in past videos. For example, we once covered how stress, among other factors, can accelerate aging in our cells. So the hypothesis is that chronic stress damages our bodies, but instead of testing that by causing stress, we try to reduce the stress and then to see if there are benefits. The Tuskegee syphilis experiments led to the requirement of informed consent. And informed consent is now standard practice. For example, we once covered how a pig transplant was transplanted into a patient. And before the transplantation, the patient had to know all the different outcomes which are possible. And then there are also rules such as participants should be treated equally, there are no privileges. If, for example, we want to test a possible HIV vaccine, and we have covered that in the past, then we randomly select who will get the vaccine and who will get a placebo. So you see, fortunately, there are many laws and guidelines in practice today. But of course, no system is perfect, and there are also different standards for different countries, and some experiments still are quite unethical. But let me know if you would be interested in unethical experiments in today's society. We can cover them as well in a future video. But for now, I hope that you find this video informative, and if so, please feel free to like it and also subscribe if you're new here and hit the bell button. And with that, I'll see ya. If you're interested in how we could reverse aging or how the first human pig transplant was conducted, you might like these videos.